Hey Dear is a many award-winning short,
but it kinda destroys what it does best, like humbug.
This reindeer with their kinda goofy design works cleaning the snow on its front yard until the Emerald Dawn?
Damn it! I just cleaned everything and DC decides to reboot again!
We see that almost everything inside the house is tied up, so the reindeer has some cocoa, checks if their favorite tree is well tethered, and goes to sleep after hearing a terrifying voice, which is followed by an earthquake and a terrible storm. And I must say, this is quite well done. We have some mystery while the rest is shown as mundane. It makes for an interesting atmosphere.
And that's kind of the problem.
The reindeer wakes up, organizes stuff, and cleans the snow again to go through the same situation once more until they can't find their shovel and need to clean the snow by hand. Since this takes longer, they get tired, end up seeing where the laugh comes from, and stay outside when the earthquake begins.
And then we see it's a snow globe.
Again, this is well presented. The animation's limitations is used to trick the spectator quite intelligently. The little snowballs and the flames are a limitation until they are revealed to be plastic flakes and cellophane. But then you have to face the inevitable fact that this means someone is keeping a living being for the amusement of that child.
Sounds like an even trade.
The ending tries to play this down, showing the girl watching TV with the reindeer, but that chair still has to be tethered. That kind of implies this poor reindeer is still going through all that, doesn't it? It might be just for safety when the globe has to be moved, but it might be because it's still shaken. And they even show the reindeer getting more tired on the second day. So I have to assume this is not an easy life, and that just makes their captivity look worse. If the house had been shown not going through this anymore, as if she had learned not to do it anymore, or we saw them treating each other as neighbors without those tethers, it'd be different. But the attitude of the short seems to be, look how cute it is that this girl cares for this lower life form.
And this problem is more difficult to forget than humbugs.
It's as if someone saw MST3K and thought the scientists were nice people because they sang. And don't even tell me she's imagining the whole thing, because if she can imagine this torturous life for the deer and smile to her face, I don't even want to imagine what kind of serial killer she's going to become. Quite smartly, quite intelligently.